love years. Greetings of the day. As we know that being art and science of teaching, pedagogy is directly linked with pedagogical researches and are now becoming popular in educational institutions. Its main thrust is to develop quality education. Of course, it is also known as rigorous disciplinary researches. The basic of pedagogical research is to contribute to a specified pedagogical approach, improved student learning, and provide guidance to policy makers. Pedagogical research allows teachers to examine their own practice, reflect on success and challenges, share experiences so many others may learn from this. The present module highlights the conceptual understanding of pedagogical research. In this module, you will be able to understand meaning of pedagogical research, characteristics and 7 steps of conducted pedagogical research. Let us start this concept by its rationale. At the outset, growing importance of pedagogical research indicates the significant contribution of enhanced quality teaching processes and the student experience. It is also perceived as a mechanism by which teachers can reflect on, practice and gain an understanding of contemporary teaching environment. It is also stated that unifying feature of pedagogical research is a desire to improve pedagogical practice. This may be from the perspective of a teacher who seeks to develop and reflect on their own practice to enhance the quality of student learning, that is action research. Similarly, pedagogic researches can operate publicly, reflecting a desire to contribute to theoretical debates and influence policy nationally, demonstrating the different auspices and audience for pedagogic research. Pedagogical researches consist of reflection and dissemination of effective teaching and learning process. It is also known as the scholarship of teaching and learning process. It is an established field of academic discourse which is directly concerned with practice and process of teaching, learning and assessment, in turn developing the curriculum. It also includes organized empirical along with contribution to pedagogic theory. Pedagogic theory hypothesizes how things should be taught and how one can bring someone to learn. These are based on learning theories. Now, I am going to explore its meaning with suitable examples. Pedagogical research is specific research concerned with teaching, learning, and assessment. It also assesses and justifies current practices. It explores in depth and effective teaching learning process and also find out how students learn successfully. This may allow us to developing teaching and learning characterized by improved competence, confidence and enthusiasm. It is strongly linked with reflection on practice, peer review of teaching and student feedback. It explores the diverse view of learner experiences within a range of different contexts that enrich the prospects for learning and individual transformation for high attainment. It includes theories of and hands-on experience for students interested in studying pedagogical practices, classroom environment, and learner context. In concluding statements, pedagogical research is observing detailed teaching process to make teaching learning process successful. It enriches theoretical and conceptual understanding of what pedagogical process, teaching and learning practices, educational experiences, teacher and student, environment or context in which pedagogical process is going on, learner and learning outcomes, relationship between pedagogical process, learner outcomes and learning context. Let us explore aims of pedagogical researches. There are specific aims of pedagogical researches as follows. Very first is to establish and validate well-versed judgments about the best ways for content delivery for increasing student learning. The second is to react appropriately about complications which occur in student learning. The third is for excellent teaching. The fourth is to evaluate and adopt new teaching models, theories and styles, etc. The fifth is to develop theory building about a specific pedagogic approach. Let us explore various characteristics of pedagogical research, which are as follows. The very first characteristic is insider research. Pedagogical researches can also be insider. It is research inside the research. This means that it may be easier to recruit research participant and the researcher who has deep understanding of the context and culture in which the research is conducted. It can be defined as a research that enhances the theoretical and or conceptual understanding of teaching and learning process, experiences, learning outcomes and context in higher education. So it can be called an insider research. Scholarship of teaching and learning. Pedagogical researches are called scholarship of teaching and learning. It is central to effort that aim to increase the effectiveness of community colleges, raise graduation rates and learns to a better educated and more effective workforce. It involves specific developments in pedagogical processes and exhibit how particular teaching methods would be high beneficial for all. The third characteristic is systematic and sustained inquiry. It is a systematic and sustained inquiry planned and subject to public criticism that can be related to the practice of education, related with what pedagogy research is not. Report of studies providing descriptive and anecdotal accounts, teaching developments and evaluations are not pedagogical research. Pedagogical research makes a sustainable contribution to the literature. Being based on formally studies in all relevant literature and high quality statements, it gives valuable contribution to the literature. Pedagogical researches are necessary for subject areas also. Pedagogical researches are concerned with content knowledge of the subject and pedagogical knowledge. It is necessary to add content knowledge with pedagogical knowledge. Pedagogical research should have a strong ethical framework. Cousin 2009 identifies two reasons why pedagogical research should have a strong ethical framework. Very one, it has a protective function for the researcher and the researched. And the second is, it supports the professional conduct of research endeavors. Encouragement to student learning. Pedagogical researches always make informed judgments, not illusions and myths about the best way to produce and present learning material that attracts the learner, qualitative and quantitative. Being empirical in nature, pedagogical research can be both qualitative as well as quantitative. In previous findings, there are evidences of using qualitative approach, but both approaches may be used to understand and investigate teaching and how best to enhance student learning. Pedagogical research involves reflection and dissemination elements. It involves reflecting on and disseminating teaching learning practice. Action research. It involves a systematic and evidence-based study of student learning in form of a small-scale research project, simply called action research. Pedagogical research is an education inquiry. It is a self-study action research. It involves critical reflection and reflexivity on current practices of teaching and learning process. It provides diverse way to new knowledge. It is just like an investigation, educational and pedagogical practices, including what works and what doesn't. The next characteristic is discipline-based pedagogy. Pedagogical researches are directly or indirectly associated with multidisciplinary researches. It is also known as rigorous disciplinary researches. The basic aim of pedagogical researches is contribution to about a specified pedagogical approach, improved student learning, and provide guidance to policymakers. After exploring meaning and characteristic of pedagogical researches, now I am going to explore 7 steps conducting pedagogical researches. The very first step of pedagogical research is identify a research question. Of course, this is first step of any research, identification of a research question. This research question originates from concerns of daily life at individual level, situation associated with common experiences within the classroom, or communicating with the student with reference to teaching learning process. National policy initiatives relevant to higher education may be taken as research question by looking beyond context and focusing on wider generic issues. Very first, set a research question that allows to explore, understand, and improve student learning in specific context. This can be discussed with colleagues and other stakeholders. The second step is considering theoretical underpinnings. In doing pedagogical researches, it is very significant to identify a theoretical framework on which to build the research question and plan the research methodology. Theoretical and conceptual framework provides base for justification for the methodology. It will establish and validate the contextualized findings. Some pedagogical researches are commonly criticized for lacking of theoretical underpinnings. Collect literature from authentic and valid sources. Prepare a review paper. Analyze and establish facts, reports, and findings revealed by pedagogical researches. Find out research gap. Now, the third step is formulate a research methodology. Pedagogical research can be based on qualitative and or quantitative data, which can be collected by using variety of techniques. The research methods used can collect qualitative data, for example, interviews, focus groups, or quantitative data via questionnaires or a mixture of both. Triangulation method helps to suit for validity of results. Research methods are of various kinds as reflection and analysis, interviews and focus group, questionnaire, content analysis, ethnography, phenomenology, etc. Keep a research journal as you undertake your work to capture your progress and thoughts that will assist with the analysis and write-up. In pedagogical research, there are various research methods to explore and scrutinize teaching learning process along with enhancement of student learning. It is essential to have a good knowledge about concerned literature, pedagogical knowledge with a particular context. Not only in pedagogical researches, but in every research, it is not essential that we must agree with the literature, but we should comment critically with reference to a particular context and experience. Basically, choosing research methodology is based on the data needed to answer the research question. The famous tool in pedagogical research are, for example, course experiences questionnaire developed by Ramsden, 1991. The second, the approaches to teaching inventory developed by Professor and Tingwell, 1999. And the assessment experience questionnaire developed by Gibbs and Simpson, 2003. Data analysis as a fourth step is a process of transformation whereby data are sorted, retrieved, and indexed to generate analytical ideas. It is important to be aware that data may be represent the meaning of people, attribute to their experiences and social worlds. The researcher also needs to consider their own positions, values, and beliefs, and how to inform their interpretations. Qualitative data can be analyzed to establish relationship or correlations and can provide statistical generalization. Qualitative data analysis involves a range of processes, for example, familiarization, sorting, coding, and indexing, which allow organization of the text to aid development of concepts or theories. Software like SPSS, supported by the university, available to assist with the sorting and management processes. You should plan your data analysis as you formulate your research design, as this can determine the data collected. Disseminate your findings. Pedagogical research may be included either through discipline-based units or through the educational units of assessment. We may send the findings of pedagogical researches in journals. There has been a growth of pedagogical research journals, and a list of generic and discipline research based can be found at deliberation equally. There are many national and international conferences dedicated to pedagogical research. Annually, organizations such as HEA, ISSOTL, and SRHE hold conferences that are generic in their focus, addressing a range of issues relating to pedagogical research, for example, students, staffs, or policy developments. Identify a critical friend who can act as a reader for articles and abstract, since they can provide useful feedback to clarify your writings. Collaborate the pedagogical research. In pedagogical researches, there are significant advantages of collaborating with others. Some of the most successful collaborators involve the combination of a researcher with an educational background who can contribute theoretical perspectives and draw on the educational literature, and a researcher from another discipline who can contribute the knowledge and perspectives from their home disciplines, as well as the first-hand knowledge of teaching and learning in that discipline. A good collaborator helps, keeps you motivated and encouraged you to write up your research, as well as making the whole experience more enjoyable. There are a considerable number of staff across the university working on pedagogical research projects. If you have an idea but are unsure who to collaborate with, talk to the professional development platforms, as they will be able to suggest potential collaborators. After exploring the different steps of conducting the pedagogical research, now it is time to explore the benefits of pedagogical research. There are various benefits of pedagogical researches are as follows. Very first, pedagogical researches enriches the learning and teaching practices and processes in better way, because it addresses the encourage teaching excellence. That is why it is of growing importance. Pedagogical researches give direction to frame and design teaching excellence framework. Pedagogical researches reflect, develop, and improve pedagogical practices. Pedagogical researches encourage better understanding of the learning and teaching environment. Pedagogical researches can make a different and unique educational experiences for learner and teachers. Pedagogical researches influence educational policy for wider context. Pedagogical researches boost interaction and collaboration between different disciplines. Pedagogical researches stimulates professional discourse, debate, and discussions. Pedagogical researches share and collaborate to all knowledge base through journals and networks. Now, in concluding statement, pedagogical research are directly related with pedagogy and pedagogical process. It is concerned with specified pedagogical approach, improved student learning, and provide guidance to policymakers for quality concerns in educational experiences. Pedagogical research is specific research concerned with teaching, learning, and assessment. In this module, we have explored meaning, purpose, characteristics, and different steps of conducting pedagogical research. Benefits of pedagogical research have also been elaborated with examples. In nutshell, pedagogical researches are highly significant for learners' inclusive growth and development in their specified learning areas. The steps of conducting pedagogical researches are similar to common education researches. Thank you. Happy learning.